Hello friends, our today's activity is needlework. We are going to learn how to sew, cross stitch and to tack a button. So let's begin. On your white kerchief or cloth, draw two lines which are 1 centimeter apart. Draw these lines on all the four sides of your cloth. So we have finished drawing lines on all the four edges. Two lines with 1 centimeter gap. We are going to learn how to sew cross stitch. So children, you see these three edges. This is how the cross stitch looks. This is a sample that I have already finished sewing so that you understand how your finished cross stitch will look. On the fourth edge, you can see that we have stitched slant lines. We are going to see how to sew these slant lines and then convert them into this cross stitch. So let's start. We will mark dots on the two lines. We will mark dots of approximately 1 centimeter apart on both the lines that we have drawn on the edge. Now first we will start with the slant, so this dot is just below. So we will continue in this pattern. So you see I finished sewing these slant lines. Now we will sew the next slant line, which is in the opposite direction. So this is the last dot we drew. We'll remove the needle from here. And then we will pass the needle on this point. Then again we pass the needle from this point. So basically you're following the same step. The only difference is that this time we already have the slant lines. Then again from the dot below, exactly opposite or below the line, and here. So see, we finished sewing the cross stitch. Now we'll learn how to tack a button. Do you see we have this button? This button has four holes. We are going to stitch the button using a horizontal stitch. So like this is the first, second, third, fourth. So from first hole the stitch will go to the second, and we will repeat this 2-3 times to secure the button nicely. Then we will come to the third hole and we will sew from 3rd to 4th, and we'll repeat this process 2-3 times to secure the button properly. So let's start. I'm sewing a button in this corner. See, I've removed the stitch. I've passed the stitch from the first hole. Now we are passing it from the second hole. We'll repeat this 2-3 times. Now I'm passing it from the third hole. Needle going in the fourth hole. We'll repeat this process. You can even stitch this in an X. See, this stitch is looking like an is equal to sign. If you want, you can stitch the button in an X pattern also, where you will pass the needle from first to third and second to fourth. So then you will get an X pattern. And we'll tie a knot on the rear side. So there we finish sewing our button.